What's up everyone, I'm Chris, we got Steph behind the camera, and we're hungry to travel. Puebla is a city of gastronomy with so many traditional Mexican dishes and a cuisine that you won't find anywhere else in the country. So today we're gonna continue our Poblano food tour. We've got some extremely tasty food coming up that you don't wanna miss, so let's get eating, come on.
We're here at Antojitos Acapulco, which is a place that specializes in antojitos, which are snacks here in Mexico. This place has been around since 1962, and what we wanted to try was this very famous and popular poblano sandwich. Now, what makes it so special is that it's made with actually fried bread. So they deep fry the bread, and you can see it's super light and crispy, and we have it piled with crema. We got salsa verde on top, shredded beef, and we've got lettuce, frijoles underneath. So this is a pretty packed looking sandwich. Ooh. Okay, so it's packed with ingredients, but because the bread is fried, it's actually quite a light feeling sandwich. All right.
Crunchy.
So crunchy. That bread is so nice and light and so crispy crunchy. Oh, I love that. And honestly, what I can taste a lot of is the lettuce, which makes it so nice and fresh. Also doesn't make it too heavy. But you've got those refried beans in there, the nice spicy salsa verde, and the beef is nice and tender. And that crema makes it so nice and creamy too. Oh, this is a really fresh tasting sandwich. Those frijoles, refried beans, so good on there too. Honestly, that fried bread just really makes it. Oh, reminds me of having fried bread with bacon and eggs as a kid. And she hollows out the bread as well, so it actually makes it even lighter than you already think it is. Honestly, it's just the perfect little snack on the go. And these antojito places are all over Puebla, and they have all kinds of little snacks. So anything from tacos to gorditas, they have tostadas, the tacos dorados, which are the flautas. So you can have a little bit of anything, quick little snack on the go. Nice thing is you get a plate to eat it outside and just enjoy it on the ledge here. But overall, I have to say, this pelona, the fried bread, is just really what makes it so unique and light and flavorful and just, oh, I'm in love with this sandwich. Perfect on-the-go snack. Muy rico. Rico. Riquísimo. So tasty.
One of the must-visit spots in Puebla City, and our personal favorite, is the Biblioteca Palafoxiana. Founded in 1646, it's recognized by UNESCO as the oldest public library in the Americas. The library houses more than 45,000 books and unique manuscripts, ranging from the 15th to 20th century. It has three major collections across a range of subjects, including 9 incunables, books printed in Europe before the year 1500. The Baroque style makes it feel like you're stepping back in time into a bygone world.
Our next
stop is to try a very traditional and popular poblano dish. This is gonna be tasty, come on.
Peanuts on the red side. Oh, sesame seeds on the mole.
Pepita.
Ah, pepita. Pumpkin seeds on the verde.
¿Tienes rábano para ti?
Queso.
Here we have our very traditional and, of course, beautiful looking dish of enchiladas tres moles. So this is a dish, obviously, of three different kinds of moles, and it's a fusion of French, Spanish, and Mexican cuisines. We've got the pipián verde, pipián rojo, and of course, the poblano mole, which is such an ancient traditional dish here in Mexico. And honestly, the smells coming off of this are incredible. Okay, I think I'm gonna start with this pipián verde first. The pipián verde is a type of mole that is made with pumpkin seeds as well as tomatillo, which gives it a very green color. There's also quite a few different herbs, so it just gives it such a nice deep green, very beautiful color. Look how thick and rich this sauce is. Oh, look at that enchilada as well. The enchiladas are a corn tortilla, just full of shredded chicken. Look at all that chicken in there. All right, let's get a nice big bite. Oh. Mmm. That sauce is so rich and flavorful. Oh my gosh. There's so many flavors going on in my mouth right now. It's really nutty from the pumpkin seeds, but it's also very earthy from the herbs and a little bit spicy from the chilies too, but not overpoweringly so. Just has a little bit of kick that it gives you there. Mmm. That is a delicious sauce. And with the chicken and the corn tortilla, it's nice because the chicken is plain, it's quite bland, so really all the flavor you're getting from is the sauce itself. That is just incredible, wow. Mmm. Mmm. Okay, I need to dive into the red one now. And I'm saving that mole, the poblano mole, for last. What gives the pipián rojo its color is the red chilies that are used. And it's also made with peanuts and sesame seeds, so it has such a rich, dark color as well. This looks so good. Oh, look at all the chicken in this enchilada. Oh, wow. And that sauce is just so thick. Look at all those peanuts in there too. Oh my gosh, I love the color. It's like peanut butter. Chris and I love peanuts, so I'm excited for this one. Mmm. Mmm. It's like eating spicy peanut butter. There's quite a bigger heat to the pipián rojo, that red one. It definitely builds more than the green one does. But just the taste of those peanuts, honestly, it's just so rich and nutty, and kind of oily a little bit too because you've got the oil from the peanuts, and almost like a slight bitterness, I think, from the sesame seeds, but not too much. It's just, it's honestly just so complex. Like there's just so much going on in your mouth. It's like a little flavor explosion. It's super tasty. But you know what? I think I need to cool it down a little bit with this massive drink that we have. They say in Mexico, everything is bigger, and this is muy grande. Mmm. Oh, that is delicious. Like a cucumber lime,
Oh, hello there.
We've got a little kitty friend over here. That is delicious though. Oh, so refreshing. And lastly, we have our mole poblano to try. Now, this is one of the signature dishes here in Puebla, and it's a very complex, deep, dark, rich sauce. You can see by the color. It's made from anywhere of 20 to 50 ingredients, can take up to 3 days to make it. And the most important ingredients are chili and cocoa chocolate. The owner was saying this one has up to 4 different chilies in it, so I think it's going to be spicy, rich, delicious. Let's just dig right in. This is the one I've been most dying to try out of this dish, so here we go. Ooh, that's got a kick to it. That heat really builds, but my goodness, that is an insanely flavorful sauce. It is just so rich with flavor. There's the cat. You can taste that little bit of chocolate with it, but those spicy chilies, they really build heat, but it's just such a complex heat. Like, it's not just spicy, there's quite a bit of flavor to it. And it also tastes very rich and nutty, most likely with the sesame seeds, but there's honestly so many different ingredients like banana, and I'm sure all kinds of nuts. There's almonds in there. So it has an oiliness to it as well, but oh my gosh, that is seriously incredible. These moles in Puebla are just on another level of food. Just look at all that nice chicken in there with the soft tortilla. Just soaking up, look at all that sauce. You can see how it's a little bit oily, but just so rich and flavorful. Oh my gosh. I just really can't get over the poblano mole. These enchiladas are just stuffed full of chicken, and even though it's plain, the mole just speaks for itself. Enchiladas tres moles is a really nice dish to try because it allows you to try all 3 different kinds of moles here in Puebla, and really gives you a taste of the history of the city being the Mexican mole as well as the Spanish influence. So you really get to taste the history of the city in such a traditional dish, and not just traditional, but beautiful. Like the presentation, the colors, everything like that, the textures from the sauces to the soft tortillas and the crunchy nuts on top is just overall incredible. And when you have such a beautiful dish of such wonderful colors, you have to end it with an ultimate enchiladas tres moles bite. Mm-hmm. 3 times the deliciousness.
Puebla is such a really nice historical city to walk around. The streets are just beautiful, and there's lovely colonial architecture everywhere. I don't know, it's just really nice.
It really is. And I think it's time for something a little refreshing to drink. That kind of drink.
Which has been around since 1916 and is actually the oldest cantina here in Puebla. So we're gonna be trying some very traditional poblano drinks. The first is pasita, which was actually invented here at this bar, so you can't find it anywhere else in the country, just at this one bar here. And it is a raisin flavored liqueur, which comes with a raisin and a piece of goat cheese on a toothpick to drink with it.
Wow, that looks super tasty. And we have a second drink here called rum pope. Now this is like a Mexican eggnog that's made with eggs, milk, sugar, cinnamon, and alcohol. And it was actually invented at the Santa Clara Convent here in Puebla. So this is a poblano drink. Both of these are technically,
yeah. Both very traditional and just made here in Puebla. So
that smells really eggy. Oh, I love it. Take a look at that color, that yellow color.
It's so thick.
Oh. It really does look like an eggnog or something like that.
Well, the bartender actually told you how to drink it, right?
Yes, so I need to take a little nibble of my cheese first before I take a sip. So how about I'll start with my nibble.
Okay.
So we can sip together. So cheers.
Cheers. No cheese here.
Here we go.
Salud.
Oh, that's hard cheese.
Salud.
Woo! That is delicious. Creamy, tastes like eggs. Oh, just cinnamony and sugary. Oh.
So this guy definitely tastes like a raisin flavored liqueur, kind of grape tasting, but that cheese, you can see, is actually quite a dense cheese there. It's like feta, and it's a little bit salty, but actually like the creaminess of it goes so well with it. You know what? It actually is almost like having cheese and wine, but like very alcoholic wine.
Alcoholic? Is it strong? Wine.
Yeah, like decently, like it's, let me have another little nibble.
This one's not strong at all. It honestly just tastes like eggnog, like a rum-based eggnog. And oh, just so creamy and delicious. I love this.
Yeah, that's got a little strength to it. It's good though, it's got a kick.
This one tastes like Christmas. Trade? Oh, it's very good.
Cheers.
Cheers, salut.
Cheers, salut.
Salut. Other patrons are in here. This is one of the most popular spots here in Puebla.
It is, and it's only open from 1 till 6, I believe, every day. So it's a really short window. So if you want to get your drink on, it's kind of like an afternoon.
Day drink on, yeah, because yeah. 1 to 6.
Yeah, you're right, you're right. Okay,
okay, let's,
well,
let's try.
Let's have a little treat here. Gotta get your bite of cheese.
Okay.
Mmm. You gotta chew it and drink it at the same time.
Salute.
Salute.
Ooh. That's much stronger than the rum pope here.
Oh, it is. Okay, this is super thick. It almost reminds me of a custard, actually. Mm. Like, it's so velvety and creamy. It's thick, and you can really taste the cinnamon. Oh my gosh. Okay, I really like this.
Right? Christmas in a glass.
It is. It pretty much is. This is delicious.
This one's good because it just tastes like
really alcoholic wine, right?
Yeah, like a really alcoholic wine. It is like a wine and cheese. Mm. Let's take a little bite of that raisin that we got here.
I forgot about the
raisin. Mmm, it's just soaking in that alcohol. It's such a good taste. Oh my gosh. Mmm. These two drinks are delicious. And this place is so cool. It's just a little...
Hasta luego!
Hasta luego! And this place is so nice. It's just a little tiny, almost hole in the wall pub.
Yeah, it is.
With cool decor, super retro, and...
Yeah, it's got all kinds of stuff from years and years and years. I mean, it's been around for 100 years, so they have all these little trinkets and knickknacks all over the place. I believe from the owners, just different things that they've brought back from their travels around the world and around
so
the country.
Cool.
So yeah,
so,
really,
so cool.
It's a really cool vibe in here. There's no seats, you just stay at the bar and have your drink.
This was a great stop, and honestly, a must visit when you're here in Puebla.
Yes, I'm glad we stopped here.
Salud again.
We needed a little something.
Salud. That is delicious. Great break to our day. We're finishing up our food tour today with a modern take on some traditional poblano dishes. Salsa verde?
Sí. Y este es rojo.
¿Arojo?
Sí.
Ah, queso.
Y cebolla.
Onion.
We're
starting off our meal with a little traditional poblano appetizer. So these are chalupes, which are a blue corn tortilla that is fried up. And we got a couple different ones with both red and green salsa, which looks spicy, delicious. They've all been covered with queso, onion, and then we got a special one, the chalupines, which are the grasshoppers. Look at those little guys. And they're fried up too, look crispy and delicious, so
let's try these out.
Let's go for it.
These look so good. A little bit greasy, pretty soft and crispy as well, so.
Cheers, cheers.
Look at that one. Plain.
And I've got the little grasshoppers here.
Those grasshoppers look nice and crunchy.
All right,
cheers.
Cheers.
Wow. Kind of wet because of the salsa that's on there, but super tasty actually.
Yeah, so they're not as crispy as I was expecting, but it's nice. There's still a little bit of crispiness to the outside, but okay, I don't know about yours because you are missing the grasshoppers, but those grasshoppers are crunchy, crispy, super tasty, delicious, and the salsa verde is spicy, a little vinegary, but not too spicy actually. It's quite mild, I would say, for salsa verde.
Yeah, the red salsa is pretty mild as well, not too spicy, and just kind of tomato-y actually. With that cheese on top too, adds a little bit of a creaminess, but I love the blue corn tortilla though.
Look at those.
Oh, they are crispy. Oh, super crunchy. Tastes like a chip, actually. Like a protein-filled
really nice.
Chip. Okay, let's try it.
Let's do it. Good, right?
The grasshopper one? Definitely my favorite. Yeah. That really makes them.
Hey, what the heck? I love when grasshoppers are fried like this because they're honestly just crispy, crunchy, tastes like a chip kind of a thing. And this is a very traditional thing to have in Puebla as well. The grasshoppers, the jalapenos. And it looks like we actually have little fried worm guys in there too. So there's quite a variety of bugs going on.
I'm loving these bugs, eating them all off the top. This is the perfect starter, so let's finish this up and get to our main event. Wow, so thick. Mole paste there, oh my goodness. So crunchy. Wow. Our main event has arrived, and this is a pork belly mole. Now, with mole being the quintessential dish here in Puebla, we just had to get another one, and with pork belly. Look how delicious this looks. The mole looks so thick, delicious. It smells so nutty and earthy, and look at those huge pieces of pork belly with the crispy skin on top. It's literally a chicharron on top, bubbled over like that. Oh my gosh, just look at the size of this pork belly. Just a huge piece of pork belly there. Okay, let's get a nice big dip of our mole here. Wow, look at that, it's so thick. Okay, cheers, oh my gosh. Oh man, wow. That pork belly is so tender and that skin uber crispy. But the mole itself is so nice and thick. It's nutty, but it actually has a sweetness to it. More sweet than other moles that we've had, actually. It's almost like the chocolate is really coming out in there. Oh, that is delicious. I love how complex moles can be here in Puebla, and every single one tastes different than the next, and this one is so delicious. And with the crispy pork belly, amazing. The mole is so rich, thick, and full of flavor. And they make their mole homemade here, and they actually sell it in packages, so you can buy their mole to bring home. I just love the mole here in Puebla. You can honestly just eat it. There's almost a banana flavor to this mole. Like I was saying, much sweeter, slightly spicy with the chilies, a bit of like that cocoa chocolatey flavor as well. But that is delicious. And we also have a blue corn tortilla here with some bananas as well. So extra banana flavor. Let's just make ourselves a little tortilla bite here with our pork belly. This tortilla is soaked in mole. Oh my goodness, look at that. Holy moly. And you can see the bananas there.
Holy moly.
This is so, holy mole. Okay. Let's get a bite of this. Extra dip mole. Those bananas and the tortilla that's just soaked in the mole. It honestly tastes like a dessert mole. With that crispy pork belly though, it's like a salty, sweet, just burst of flavor. I really love it. Oh, look at this. Honestly, mole is such an incredible dish. It is so complex with all the ingredients used, the flavors. They're all so different as well. You can have 100 different moles here in Puebla and not one would taste the same. And this one here, this modern take with the use of pork belly, is just out of this world. I mean, how could you go wrong with pork belly? Jeez. Perfect. All right, that's a wrap on our food tour here in Puebla today. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, give it a thumbs up, and share it with your friends and family. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel to join us on all of our food adventures. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.